In this video, I want to point out to you the policies that are included in your DFTG 1405 syllabus, and also talk about the first homework assignments for this course. If you look at your syllabus, at the back of the syllabus, you're going to find a section that talks about health and safety protocols, and I'm trying to get a marker here, health and safety protocols, and it goes through ACC's current protocols for COVID-19, and if you're not going to be on campus, you won't have to worry about this, and very few people are going to be allowed on campus. So I'm just pointing this out to you that this is available. I recommend that you read through this, and you'll notice, of course, that facial coverings or masks are required for anyone entering an ACC building. ACC also has a health screen app that you need to download if you're going to be coming onto campus, and you can get that app here. And on the app, you're asked to fill out some information, some questions, before you try to come onto the campus. So once you're on campus, there are certain protocols. There are classroom protocols, and then there are deep cleaning protocols. Now, in 1405, none of you will probably be coming onto campus, at least not for this course. You might be coming on for some other reason, but you're not required to come onto campus in this course. There's even more stuff about illness and travel and all those things. So please read that. It's at the back of your syllabus. The other thing located in the back of your syllabus is an overview of campus operations during the COVID-19 pandemic. There is also a statement on academic integrity, which I covered in orientation video one. This one includes the general ACC academic integrity procedures and policies. The A&E CAD program, because of the nature of what we do, may look a little different than the general ACC policies on academic integrity. Also, you will find student rights and responsibilities. You will find Senate Bill 212 and Title IX reporting requirements, so you should read through those sorts of things. A lot of this is probably going to be more common when we are back on campus and face-to-face than it will be online. But, of course, I guess somebody could be stalked online for sure. So if anything like that were to happen, we definitely want to report that and comply with the rules. There is a policy for student complaints. There is a statement on privacy. I think you should read through both of those and let me know if you have any questions. One of the things that is important to us on privacy is we protect your privacy by complying with some rules called FERPA, which is the Family Educational Rights and Privacy Act. And that is one of the reasons why it's so important that whenever we communicate with you, that we use your official ACC Gmail account. So as I had said earlier, if you send me an email from an account other than your Gmail account, I may not reply to that, but instead I may reply to your ACC Gmail account. The policy on recording inside class is covered here. You should read through those. The safety statement. There's a policy. It's written about campus carry. About a discrimination-free environment here at ACC. It's very important to us. There's another blurb about the use of ACC email included in the policies. Use of the testing center. You will not be required to use the testing center in DFTG 1405. Student support services. There is a wide array of student support services available to you through ACC. I recommend that you read through all of those as well. There is academic support, and as I said, our department will offer tutors that can help you with CAD, but you know, if you're taking a math class or an English class, they have tutors as well. Library services are still available, just primarily online. And so, you know, you'll have to just check with the libraries at ACC, and I'm sure you can get to that online at AC through ACC's website. There are student organizations. I imagine that anything they're doing is totally online. There's plenty of personal support. If you have problems related to mental health, a personal crisis, budgeting, there's even a student emergency fund, things like that that may be available that could help you out. And there's crisis hotline numbers included on here. And there's a final blurb on illness, all right, especially with the exposure or symptoms of COVID-19 virus. But because we won't be face-to-face, we probably won't have to deal with any of that. There are also listed at the back of your syllabus the AnyCAD department course policies, and one of those is our attendance and class participation. So students that don't participate, who don't ever come to online meetings, or if it's clear that you're not accessing Blackboard, you could be dropped from the class for lack of participation. And you should be aware of that. The withdrawal policy, we've already covered that earlier in the syllabus, but we repeat it here. I want to reiterate that if your instructor gives you a due date and says there will be a penalty for being late, that is perfectly all right within our department, as long as you know that that's a possibility. Ownership of student work. Colleges reserve the right to retain student work. They could be used for purposes of assessment, documentation, accreditation, those sorts of things. We would definitely let you know, probably anyway, if we were going to use anything like that. Work done in DFTG 1405 is usually not the kind of work that we would show off, you know, if we were trying to recruit students or something to the program. More likely it would be in one of the advanced courses, and we would talk to you about it beforehand. And as I mentioned in orientation video too, most students see it as sort of a compliment to be asked if we can use your work. Cell phones and electronic devices, obviously, because we are working remotely, we don't have to worry about those. But in a classroom, those can be very distracting. And so when we get back to face-to-face, we just ask students to mute their phones and not text during class and those sorts of things. So anyhow, hopefully we'll get to practice these things soon when we're back face-to-face. If you have any questions, shoot me an email. What's next? Okay, well, we have two assignments that will be due by the next live online class meeting. That will be in a couple of days. So the first thing I want you to do is to log into Blackboard. All right. So you may have to go in and establish your ACC EID and then log in to Blackboard. And then I want you to look in the left navigation, and you're going to find a link that says Orientation Video and Agreement. Click on that with the left button of your mouse. That will take you to this page in Blackboard. It will look like this, and it will say Orientation Step 1. Watch the DFTG orientation video. Now, actually, there are going to be three videos there. Orientation video 1, which covers the syllabus. Video 2, which covers the degrees and certificates that the department awards. And orientation video 3, which is actually this video that you're watching right now. And so after watching those videos, what you need to do is click on this link right here. And what that does, it's going to take you to what appears to be a test, but actually it's just a group of questions that ask you things like, I received the syllabus for DFTG 1405. And, you know, it's just questions pertaining to the syllabus. And at the end, you answer those. I think there are 7 questions. And when you get to the end, you just press the submit button. You answer each one, press submit, And what that does, it automatically goes into my gradebook and indicates that you have watched the orientation videos and you have received a copy of the syllabus and you understand how this class is going to work. That is assignment one. When you're finished with that, you will go back to Blackboard and click on the Chapter 1 curriculum right here. Click on that, and that's going to take you to a page. And what you're going to do is you're going to watch a video first. And all you need to do is double-click on this link right here when you get there and watch the video. This covers Chapter 1, and it talks about the field of technical drawing. Step one, because we don't consider that a step. In steps one and two, we would like you to read pages 14 through 24 in the textbook. And if you don't have the textbook yet, you can read this PDF right here. Just click on that. What that will do, it'll download the PDF, and then you may have to go to your downloads folder and double click on the PDF named Chapter 1 Technical Drawing. If it doesn't open automatically, you may have to go to your downloads and pick on that. Now, the next step is you're going to move right down here. It says Step 2, Take the Chapter 1 Review Test. You're going to click on this test right here, and that's going to take you to, I believe it's 11 questions. And again, it's an online form. You will answer those questions. And when you get to the bottom, you'll pick Save and Submit. And that will go directly into my gradebook in Blackboard. So I'll be able to see, and it'll be graded automatically. And so we want you to answer the questions at the end of Chapter 1. And that is the second assignment that you'll have before the next live online Google Meet. So two assignments. One is to go to the orientation video right up here and submit the agreement, answer the questions and submit the agreement. And then second, you will go and click on the Chapter 1 curriculum, watch the video, read the PDF or read in your textbook, and then take this test right here and be sure and press Save and Submit when you're done. All right, that is your assignment, and I will see you next time in class.